Yani Hashem Ofecha, I am your doctor. I am the one who heals you. That is what the pasuk says, and this gives us a chance to speak about refuah. When one is sick, we normally wish him refuah shleima. What is refuah shleima? Why isn't it sufficient to wish him refuah? What is shleima? Complete. What does this mean? Moshe Feinstein and a Satmar Rebbe once met. And Moshe asked the Satmar Rebbe, "You're a Rebbe, and therefore all day long people come to you and ask your brachos, and you give sick people bracha refuah shleima. What do you mean when you say shleima? Why add this word? Why can't it be sufficient just to say refuah?" And the Satmar Rebbe said to Reb Moshe, "You're a Rav, so tell me, what do you mean when you daven and you ask Hashiveinu b'tshuva shleima? You ask for a tshuva shleima. Why isn't it sufficient just to say tshuva? What do you gain by adding tshuva shleima?" And Reb Moshe explained to him, the Rambam says that when one does tshuva in a complete form, it needs to be up to the point that Ya'ida lav yodea ta'alumos, the one who knows all the secrets, HaKodesh Baruch Hu, will be able to testify as if on the person that he will never repeat the sin. He will never go back to sinning. That is what tshuva shleima means. Not only am I repenting for what I did in the past, I'm in a new place where I will never go back to that sin. Satmar Rebbe told him, based on what you're saying, now we understand what does refuah shleima mean. Not only should the person be healed, he should also never become sick with this again. And with that he explained, the bracha of Geula and Shmonesa, according to Nusach Sfad, we ask for Geula Shleima. What is Geula Shleima? You should come out of all the tzaros, and the tzaros should never repeat, should never come again.